So we have seen in the latest quiz that the one-bit predictor works reasonably well for loops that have a lot of iterations. So what are the problems with one-bit prediction that have led to better predictors? The one-bit predictor predicts well branches that are always taken. It might make a mistake the first time it sees the branch, but after that it's going to start predicting taken, and because the branch is always taken, it always works well. Similarly, always not taken is predicted well, because the very first time it might mispredict, but after that it learns the behavior and it stays the same. So we just have the always not taken. It also predicts well the branches where the number of taken outcomes is vastly more than the number of not taken outcomes. Here, it's going to learn after the first taken outcome that the next outcome should be predicted taken, and very, very rarely it's going to be wrong because of a not taken outcome. Similarly, the one-bit predictor predicts well when the number of not taken outcomes is vastly more than the number of taken outcomes, for the same reason. Basically, we will see not taken, not taken, not taken many, many times. The first time we see one of those, we're going to learn it, and then the taken outcome will be mispredicted. So what's wrong with the one-bit predictor? What's wrong with it can be glimpsed from these. Let's look at a branch that is, for example, more taken than not. So it's been taken many times, and then there is a non-taken outcome, and then it's going to be taken many more times. Let's now look at whether the one-bit predictor will be right on this. It's been taken many times, so it's going to predict taken, and then because it's been taken, it's going to predict the next one is taken, the next one is going to be predicted taken, taken again. When we reach the not taken outcome, the last outcome was taken, so we will have a misprediction. This would not be much of a problem if not taken occurs very rarely, because we're basically mispredicting just the very rare occurrences. However, there is an interesting problem here, which is now that we are back to our taken behavior, which is the vastly dominant behavior in this case, the last outcome was now not taken, so we're going to mispredict this branch too. Now we're predicting not taken and the branch will be taken. After this, the previous outcome was taken, so we predict taken and we continue predicting taken. So the problem really is that each anomaly, such as we have a branch that is almost always taken, but sometimes it's not taken, results in two mispredictions. One for the anomalous behavior, and then once more for the normal behavior that follows the anomaly. So the one-bit predictor will not do so well when the branch is biased towards, let's say, doing more taken branches, but the number of not taken branches is still significant, or when there is more not taken branches, but the number of taken branches is significant. Because for each of the less dominant behavior, it's going to do two mispredictions, not just one. Typically also, a branch predictor like this will not do well on short loops. Why? Because in a short loop, we have a branch that, for example, exits the loop, then we have some loop behavior, and then a branch that loops back. The branch that exits the loop will be predicted correctly as long as we stay in the loop by this predictor. The exit from the loop will be mispredicted. The branch predictor will now be trained to take this path here. When we come back to this short loop, it's going to mispredict the very first iteration for this branch, because now it's going to think that it should be this way, but in fact now we're staying in the loop. So if you have, for example, an 8 iteration loop, we will have two mispredictions every 8 iterations. One at the end of the loop and one at the beginning of the loop, because the previous ending of the loop trained the predictor that way. And then, of course, the one-bit predictor will be pretty bad when the number of taken and not taken outcomes is similar yet predictable. We will talk about this more later, but now let's first devise a predictor that will fix this. So can we devise a predictor that behaves similarly well here, but does not mispredict twice whenever there is an anomaly?